Hello everyone, my name is Andrew Wong and I'm a systems specialist at Con Edison in the IT Analytics Center of Excellence group. I would like to thank the C3.AI team for giving me the opportunity to talk about our experience with the C3 AI Ex Machina application. Before we get into the details, I would like to offer a brief overview about our company and what we do to set the stage. Con Edison is a regulated utility that services customers in New York City, Westchester, and Orange and Rockland counties. Our core business is to deliver energy via three commodities: electricity, natural gas, and steam. Our customer base is approximately 5 million across Con Edison Company of New York and Orange and Rockland Utilities. Our company operates around three main pillars: safety for our workers and the public, ensuring we deliver a plus one customer experience, and always striving for operational excellence. Con Edison's partnership with C3.AI began in mid-2017, when we launched our biggest project to transform our metering infrastructure from legacy to the modern era by deploying smart meters via implementation of advanced metering infrastructure, AMI for short. To date, we have integrated 27 data sources with the C3 AI suite and leveraged 6 C3.AI applications. We have also deployed 29 production use cases that are consumed by 7 core business units: AMI Electric, Rate Engineering, Energy Management, Customer Operations, Electric Operations, Energy Efficiency, and Grid Operations. One of the primary benefits of the AMI project is the amount of information the smart meters generate. It can range from customers getting better insight into their energy consumption to operational advancements that would allow our company to detect issues before they impact the customer or the public at large. We needed a platform and supporting applications that can make sense of all of this data and provide actionable insights for our operational teams. We had many legacy data sources where it was not easy to relate them to each other. We also needed a way to easily track our progress towards completing the deployment of smart meters across our service territory. Knowing these challenges, we needed to build a cohesive team framework to execute effectively and efficiently. At a high level, we have IT, business units, and C3.AI teams. Business units provide the use case, expected business value, if implemented, and the associated funding to implement the solution. Business units are comprised of business analysts, business sponsors, and use case subject matter experts. C3.AI provides guidance and best practices on how best to utilize their products to accomplish our goals. So the C3.AI team is composed of a delivery manager, solutions architects, and software engineers. Within our IT department, we have 2 primary groups. The IT support team provides all the necessary data inputs to satisfy use cases. The IT support team is composed of subject matter experts in data sources, data governance, and data compliance, in addition to middleware specialists for data transfer needs. The Analytics Center of Excellence, ACE for short, provides the resources to bring these analytics needs to fruition. ACE also serves as the liaison between the C3.AI experts and the business units to ensure everyone is on the same page when it comes to delivering a final product. The ACE team is composed of data analysts, data scientists, business liaisons, and subject matter experts in data integration and the C3.AI suite. We develop most of the solutions in-house if the request is for Ex Machina models or ad hoc reporting needs, and the C3.AI team would be engaged if we have a successful model and an automated solution is desired. We now have a basic understanding of the team breakdown and the challenges, so the question to answer is, how do we overcome them? C3 AI Ex Machina helps in addressing each of our challenges in the following ways. All data in the C3.AI platform is standardized into business-defined entities that are related to each other in one or more ways, which makes it easy to get a single pane of glass view into the data elements of interest. The highly performant analytics engine enables our end users to parse through many data points across various perspectives via normalization of time series data. C3 AI Ex Machina offers pre-built visualizations that enable our end users to obtain immediate insights into their analyzed data. And lastly, Ex Machina also provides us a framework to prototype new use cases that may eventually be transformed into custom application modules that are automated and deliver a great user experience. Let us put into practice what I have spoken about thus far by going through a user story. We had a use case with our AMI operations team centered around the detection of overheating meters. Our challenge was trying to get ahead of meters that were overheating, so we address the issue before it has an impact on the customer or the public. The vendor solution the team was using would only trigger alarms if it hit a specific threshold. Unfortunately, the threshold was at the point of overheating, and as a result, it may have become a safety issue or impacted the customer service. This was their main pain point. So in essence, we were tasked with developing a solution that was proactive rather than reactive. We started with an Ex Machina model that allowed for evaluation of time series data to correlate meter temperature, ambient temperature, and customer load or consumption. From there, we identified possible meter temperature thresholds that could be used as warnings to enable proactive identification of potential trouble meters. The Common Information Data Model offered us the visibility into other characteristics of the smart meter and the customer associated with it, a 360-degree view of the potential trouble meter, if you will. C3 AI Ex Machina also enabled our end users to enrich the analyzed data with their own datasets through file connectors such as CSV or Excel. This model eventually transformed into an extension of the C3 AI AMI operations application and is now a UI component with a great user experience of managing the lifecycle of at-risk meters from identification through issue resolution. Here's a brief demonstration of the Ex Machina model for hot sockets.
So this is our Ex Machina project model for the hot socket use case. To start off, we have a data input, which leverages a data node, specifically the file system node. And this file system node is configured to connect to an Amazon Web Services S3 bucket, which is basically a folder in the cloud, to retrieve data. So if we open up the node here, we can see that it has some basic information. Specifically, we'll be focusing on the meter ID column here, which is just the meter numbers of the suspect meters that may be overheating. We have these data preparation columns, which can be found over here in this preparation submenu. And as you can see, there are a lot of basic types of data transformation, data manipulation type of actions. In this case, we're just subsetting the data set to only look at the meter ID column. And we're just going to drop duplicates on that column because meters could potentially get flagged multiple times over time. Once we have our focused meter set, we're going to retrieve some relational data from the C3 platform through this C3 filter node. And the C3 fetch node here is retrieving that relational data. Specifically, we are looking to get GPS data, account information, as well as some address information. And here we will be setting our time series analytics that we want to run. So in this case, we're focusing on the meter temperature, the ambient temperature, and the customer's consumption or load. In this node, we are basically setting the parameters for the time series evaluation. So we're going to be looking at data from the 19th up to the 22nd of January 2021 at the hour grain because the meter temperature data comes in every hour. And here we're just doing some simple aggregation via group by to look at what was the maximum meter temperature data point for each of the suspect meters. And we're just doing some data cleanup here, removing any missing data points, and also joining the relational data set with the aggregate data set to get that full view. So to demonstrate the visual capabilities of this application, we have this meter temperature trend view, which will demonstrate the line chart visualization. So you have your three time series analytics as well as a timestamp column. So when we go here to create the line chart, we'll have to set up the series and the x-axis. So in this case, we'll go ahead and just do each of those three time series analytics, so ambient temperature, and we're just going to choose a single meter for demonstration purposes, and we can give them custom labels as well. So here we'll just call these ambient temperature, and we're going to put the temperature related time series analytics onto the secondary axis, secondary y-axis. So that's the first one, and then we'll have two more. So this one will be meter temperature. And we'll select the same meter. And here we'll just call this meter temperature for the label, put it on the secondary axis. And lastly, we will add the customer's consumption and keep that on the primary Y axis. And then we'll just call this customer consumption. And then we have to set up our X axis, which is going to be our time axis, which in this case will be the timestamp. And we're just going to set the same parameters as the time series time frame node that I showed before, which would be at the hour grain and starting on the 19th and ending on the 22nd. So now that we have all those settings, we'll go ahead and evaluate this. And as you can see, this line chart renders, which gives us immediate insights into some correlations that we could potentially make. So what we want to focus on is the correlation between the customer's consumption and the meter temperature, the green and red lines, respectively. So as you can see here, there was a huge spike in the meter temperature from 1,200 hours on the 20th to 1,300 hours on the 20th. But the consumption for those same timeframes didn't really increase accordingly. So it actually went from 0.09 kilowatt hours at 1,200 hours down to 0.087 kilowatt hours. So this immediate spike over the course of that hour could either be a bad data point or it could be indicative of something potentially going wrong with the meter. But either way, the end user of this application or of this model would want to investigate this to really clear out any doubts. So that was the line chart. And as you can see, it was relatively easy to kind of make some assumptions or, you know, try to establish some correlations between the various time series data points. So let's go ahead and demonstrate also the geospatial visualization, which is a Google Maps component. And I'll run this again. And here we have some relational data along with the maximum high temperature. So we can go to the geospatial view and set our properties accordingly. And we'll want to base the map marker color on the maximum high temperature. And the label content will essentially be the tooltip information that we want to show. So in this case, we'll want to show all these data elements. And we'll want to group by the borough. And we'll go ahead and select all the boroughs that we have available to us. And we'll render the visual and zoom in a bit to see the breakout. So from here, the main benefit to this visual is to kind of see where all your suspect trouble meters are located. So in this case, we can see that there's a relatively high concentration, you know, of the 5 meters. Three of them are within the Bronx, and then we have one in Brooklyn and one in the White Plains. The darker the color of the marker, the higher the temperature. So we want to kind of look at the worst first, which would be this one. And as you can see, there's some of this tooltip information, which kind of gives you that immediate insight as to, you know, what the meter is and, you know, where it's located, generally speaking, and also some high level information. So that pretty much wraps it up in terms of the visualization demonstrations. This is just really scratching the surface of what Ex Machina is capable of. So, I mean, in this AI submenu here, there's plenty of artificial intelligence and machine learning models that are industry standard built in. So this is really a great tool for any data analyst or data scientist. And that'll be it for the demo. Thank you.
As you can see, C3 AI Ex Machina has proven to be one of the most used applications at Con Edison in the C3 AI suite. Its easy-to-use drag-and-drop interface, along with its powerful capabilities ranging from data transformation to scalable data analysis to implementation of industry-standard machine learning models, makes it a great tool for any data analyst or data scientist. With that said, what is next for C3 AI Ex Machina at Con Edison? We have a lot of use cases in the pipeline, primarily centered around AMI, such as load aggregator and unreachable smart meter analysis. But we also have use cases around rate case analysis with rate engineering, among many other groups. As new business units and use cases are onboarded, we expect C3 AI Ex Machina to see many more applications, and we look forward to the future improvements the C3.AI team will make to this tool. Thank you for your time and attention. With that, we will move on to the Q&A section.